Hey, my name is Speed Wobble. Welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to efficiently procrastinate maxing in old school RuneScape. Let's get it. Now, if you're anything like me, you've been playing this game for a long time. And let's face it, there's no going back now. No other game is going to hit that sweet, sweet dopamine button quite like RuneScape does. You're trapped. Now, you may be wondering, why wouldn't I want to max? Isn't that basically the end goal of RuneScape? It is. It's the end goal. We don't want this sweet journey to end anytime soon. So we're going to ride that wave of procrastination all the way to the bank. So, I've been procrastinating maxing for over 5 years, and today I'll be sharing all my tips and tricks with you. So the first thing you need to know about procrastinating is, there's always something else you could be doing. You don't have to be playing RuneScape and making gains. You could be doing literally anything else. And I'm not here to tell you what to do with your life. I'm not telling you to go outside, hang with your girlfriend, do anything crazy. I mean things we can do to procrastinate in RuneScape. These are my current stats. Quite a few 99s, mostly the good ones that I enjoy, like Slayer and farming, some AFK skills that I trained on mobile, and combat stats that help with PVM. Die. Being this close to max, I often get questions from friends and clanmates. People are asking things like, "Hey, Wobble, maxing when?"
"Wow, so many skills close to 99. Why not just get it?"
But these poor noobs don't understand. I'm not here to make gains. I'm here to make excuses. Well, the reason for my crafting and mining at 98 is so I can efficiently train them alongside runecrafting when I go runecraft blood runes. Boom. One excuse bomb, three skills. Although, I should probably get 99 agility first, so I never run out of stamina while runecrafting. But I want to train at Sepulchre to get the Dark Acorn recolor for my giant squirrel pet. But I can't AFK Sepulchre on mobile, so when I'm on PC, friends are always asking me to help teach raids. Act like the victim to get them on your side. Construction and herb lore cost money, so it's more efficient for me to save that money up for a site and go run Theater of Blood to make more money faster. Cooking. Yeah. I'm tactically saving cooking for when I burn out doing those other big grinds. Now that you've exhausted all possible excuses, set other goals that conveniently get in the way of you maxing. So I was actually on my way to the Sepulchre to go train agility, right? And then I go past the Vyres and I realize, wow, the blood shard's at 7.5 mil? So naturally, maybe I think I could get one of those. Turns out you can also get it from thieving Vyres. And with the Rogue's outfit, you can get two at a time. So I went to the Rogue's Den and spent 10 hours getting full Rogues. Then I went to go thieve the Vyres, and 10,000 pickpockets later, I still don't have the blood shard drop. But I'm too deep to quit now, so I have to stay here until it all pays off. Also, Rocky would be really cool. Okay, so I took the whole procrastinating thing a little bit too far, and outside of RuneScape, I've been procrastinating making this video for like 3 weeks, and now I'm in a whole new place. Like, check it out. We're chilling. We got Jad here. We're set up. We got the plants. Like, it's pretty prime, honestly. Anyways, the third thing we should be doing to procrastinate maxing is probably the most important. Help out your friends and clanmates. Help the noobs out, you know? Give them a little something. You can show them that high-level players aren't just people who raid all the time and piss in buckets, even if some of them do. It's cool. It's fine. It's fine. I just prefer to pee in a toilet. It's just me. So, the main noob that I help out is my buddy Freckles. It's spelt with a W. It's supposed to sound like Fweckles, because he's a widow baby. And this guy's a mess. He needs help. He's like the alpha noob. So, the first thing this kid needed was some runecrafting levels. So, I was like, sure, I can help you out, man. I'll run some pure essence for you, so you can go craft lava runes. It's the fastest XP in the game. Like, I'll just run it for you for free for a bit, and, you know, I'll help you out. Here's how it went.
You about to hit that magic imbue?
Yep.
Sick, let's go. Oh, we don't have tiaras.
Okay, now magic and view. Alright, sick. Let's go.
Okay, so I'll just do that. Do this. And then telegroup.
No, trade me, trade me. I have more. Oh. I'm gonna trade. We're gonna trade twice each time. Yeah, telegroup Moon Clan.
Yeah. Speed Wobble won't let you teleport them. Your aid turned off.
Okay, it's back on. Next time. Christ. Next time.
Okay, so what I do is I click the mysterious rune, right? And then when I pass the little plant, I hit magic and view.
Okay.
Then there's no animation. Then I run up and empty my bags on the altar. And I put my lava runes in the pouch.
And oh, I didn't get any more runes. All right. Telegroup Moon Clan, for sure.
Okay, this is fairly click intensive.
Yeah, dog. It's rune crafting. And we're trading each other the whole time, but this is kind of sick.
My binding necklace ran out. I only made that last batch. I only made 8 lava runes. Oh, fuck's sake.
You just gotta get in the groove, man. Get in the groove and we'll be smooth sailing. You're almost at 77 by now, right?
Yeah, like pretty much.
What are you at?
67.
Oh, shit. Well, what's your XP per hour right now? It's gotta be huge. It's gotta be like 100k an hour.
16k?
16k an hour?
Yeah.
There's no way.
Yeah, dude.
Wait, how long do we have to do this for?
That's why I just want to do diaries.
All right, that's it. Enough. Enough runecrafting. We're done. We can't do this anymore. That's a wrap. So the next thing he needed is a Calphite Queen kill for the desert diary. So we geared up and we headed out to the desert. Unfortunately, Discord stopped recording, so I don't have his side of the audio, but I've got mine. Maybe I'll just do a little ad lib for him and fill in the blanks. And here she is.
Oh my god, I'm so scared.
Got one hit. I got two hits. Okay, cool. You can rock your BGS specs.
All right, I'm ready to swing my BGS. Whoop-a! Nice and big. Okay, I'll just swing it like this. Uh-uh!
All right, now walk under and just do one-to-one attacks. So, you know, you come out like that. Now you under. Good job. Okay, stand under her. Make sure you're underneath her. Switch to your range gear. Put on range prey and rigor. And then you're gonna wanna step back from her. So attack and then step back.
So this avoids melee hits?
And yeah, start blasting.
So I started blasting.
And if you need to heal up, you can walk under and go heal. There you go.
Oh my god, yes, I did it. Oh, I'm so happy. Thank you, Speedwobble. Thank you. You're the best.
So after finishing off Calphite Queen, he got lucky at Demonics. So he got a Zenite shard and he wanted a Tormented Bracelet made. So I crafted the Zenite for him. And I made the Tormented Bracelet, enchanted it, and right here, this is where we scam him. We gained his trust, we got him to give us items that are valuable, now we dip. This is where we exit. Disclaimer, don't go trading your items to random people, even if you think that you can trust them. Nah, I'm just kidding. We gave him the jewelry. So now we know how to procrastinate maxing, but I still feel like I haven't answered why. The Max Cape, it's the best utility item in the game, and not to mention a huge status symbol. So, isn't this game all about flexing on everyone with better and better capes? Well, if you're anything like me, maybe you told your girlfriend that after you max, you'd be done with the game. And there's some promises you just can't keep.